health advocates. Something super scary happened to me the other day, and I've been meaning to tell you. Okay, so I was walking home, minding my own business, when out of the blue, this loud, jarring bark shattered the peace. And it was coming from right behind me. Instantly, my heart started racing, my muscles tensed up, and I was ready to either run or defend myself. So I whipped around, and all I could hear was the barking. And then eventually I saw the dog, and he was safely on a leash with his owner. And so after that, I started to calm down. But the feeling of fear and stress was so palpable that it got me thinking about how our bodies react to stress. Stress is a natural part of life that is meant to help us out, but how do we determine what's a healthy amount of stress? Wait, is there even such a thing as healthy stress? Before we work our way into the lesson, take a moment to think about your own experience with stressful situations. What has caused stress for you in the past? In today's lesson, we'll be learning all about stress. We'll examine if stress can be healthy for you, and we'll take a look at the effects of chronic or long-term stress. Let's get into it. Stress is a physical or mental response to an external cause. Stress is a reaction, not an emotion, and it's something that everyone experiences. External causes of stress might include a new, unfamiliar, or threatening situation. These stressors may occur once or repeatedly over a long period of time. When you experience a stressor, your body releases adrenaline and cortisol. You may have heard of the fight or flight response. That's a stress-based reaction geared to keep you safe. When your body perceives something as frightening or threatening, your nervous system releases chemicals that increase your heart rate, dilate your pupils, slow your digestion, and prime your body to either fight the threat or flee quickly. This was just what my body was doing when I heard that big dog barking behind me. It was an acute stress reaction. This is a brief, intense reaction to an immediate threat, which subsided once the danger, in this case, the barking dog, was no longer present. Think about a time when you experienced an acute stress response. Maybe you were about to give a presentation, or maybe you were trying something new for the first time. How would you describe the physical sensation of stress? Pause the video here to write your thoughts down in your notes. Nice work. Just like emotions, stress serves a purpose for us. It's a survival and coping mechanism that our body has developed to keep us safe. Most people view stress as something that is always a bad thing, but there are some benefits to certain types of stress. When do you think that stress could be healthy? Stress can be a way of your body protecting and strengthening itself. For example, heavy exercise puts your body under stress. This type of stress is beneficial because it's temporary and you're strengthening your body over time by developing resilience. Eustress is the term for positive stress. It's the kind of stress that feels exciting and helps motivate you. Eustress makes you feel energized. For example, eustress can motivate you to do your best in a basketball game or nail that dance routine on stage for a performance. Take a second to think about when you've experienced positive stress. What happened and how did you feel? Pause the video for a moment to jot down your thoughts. Eustress is usually short-term and associated with a feeling of excitement and accomplishment. It's a little like that rush you get after you ride a roller coaster. This type of stress is beneficial because it pushes you to grow and achieve without overwhelming you. However, stress that lasts for a long time and originates from a negative stimulus can cause health issues. Chronic stress, also known as long-term stress, is stress that lasts for weeks, months, or even years. It's different from the brief stressors that pass quickly, and chronic stress can have lasting impacts on your health. One of the main reasons chronic stress is harmful is due to prolonged exposure to cortisol. Cortisol is helpful in short bursts, but when it's released continuously over long periods, it can wear down your body's systems, leading to health problems. Chronic stress can be caused by many different stressors. You could experience chronic stress from a sudden negative change in your life, such as an illness or a loss of a loved one. You could also experience chronic stress from a traumatic event, such as a bad accident or a natural disaster. These are intense causes, but chronic stress can also be caused by routine pressures in your daily life. Maybe there are school, work, or social challenges that you're facing. The pressure of your routine can contribute to chronic stress if it is not properly managed. Remember, how we handle stress varies from person to person. What might be a minor annoyance for one person can be a major source of stress for another. That's why it's important to recognize your own stressors and how they affect you. While stress reactions are highly individualized, we do have some information on the physical symptoms of chronic stress. When experiencing chronic stress, young adults often feel irritable, easily angered, or sad. Oftentimes, they have trouble sleeping and they experience headaches, muscle tension, and digestive issues. Those who have chronic stress may also be more prone to falling ill because chronic stress can reduce the immune response. Because the stress response causes your body to react like it's in danger, there are some serious long-term health effects from chronic stress as well. Over time, it can lead to increased risks of depression, anxiety, diabetes, stroke, heart disease, and even high blood pressure. All right, let's quickly recap what we've covered today. We started off by understanding that stress is a natural and common response to external causes. We learned that it's not just an emotion, but a physical and mental reaction everyone experiences at some point. We explored two types of stress: acute stress, like my encounter with a barking dog, which is intense but short-lived, and chronic stress, which lasts for a longer period and can have significant impacts on our health. We also discovered that not all stress is bad. New stress or positive stress can be energizing and motivating, helping us to achieve goals and grow. On the flip side, chronic stress, which can stem from ongoing challenges in our daily lives or from more intense events, can lead to serious health issues if not managed properly. The good news is that we have lots of tools in our toolkit to manage chronic stress, which we'll be covering in our next lesson. Until then, I'm Caroline, and remember, stress is a part of life, but understanding it is the first step to managing it. So next time you feel that rush of stress, take a moment to listen to what your body is telling you. It's all part of your journey in becoming the healthiest version of yourself. I'll see you next time.